gorgeous. Take a picture of that. Oh my God, guys, I'm in Singapore and there is a Garrett popcorn here in Singapore. I kid you not, if I was ghetto, I would take this mug with me, but.
Because it's actually a casino hotel.
Morning from Singapore. Man, it is 10 o'clock in the morning and it's already 80 degrees out here. And I am on the 18th floor. I am moving up in the world. Anyway, I had a good night's sleep. I slept about 6 hours and I'm ready to explore. Look at my view from the 18th floor. It's downtown. Hope you guys enjoyed the sunrise this morning. I surely did. Anyway, I am starving, so I'm gonna head down and get some breakfast here in Singapore. And I have a craving for some Chinese rice. I don't know why, so I'm gonna have that for breakfast and maybe some nice cracked egg over it. Divine. And then I think I'm gonna do the hop on, hop off bus tour around the city for a 24-hour thing. It's one of the best ways to get around. And I'm coming back here for Christmas with my husband, so I don't wanna do too much. So I just wanna get an idea of what's here, so then I can be the tour guide for him. Anyway, and then tonight I'm meeting a couple of crew members and we're gonna do the laser show on one of the rooftop decks of the hotels here somewhere. So I got a packed day today, and then tomorrow morning I'm leaving back to San Francisco on the nonstop. A little bit better time, I think it's only a 16-hour flight back home. And then I'm off for the weekend, I have one more trip, and then I'm on vacation. Yes, sorry. But I'll see you guys in a bit. Bye, girl, bye. Their fitness center is pretty nice in the pool and spa area, so I might end up having massage here, but not too expensive. Someone said to go across the street, but I don't know about this back corner massage places, but yeah, it's beautiful. So I booked the guided city tour, so I ain't gotta think about anything, just let them do the talking. But it's about 10 o'clock here. I gotta meet them in the lobby at 1 o'clock, so I'm gonna go get some breakfast. And the concierge said there's a mall right across the street that has great restaurants. So I will do that. I need some coffee too, wake my butt up. I hear this hotel's in a great location, so I can't go wrong. It looks like it's sprinkling a little bit too, a little rain, but it's humid. Not only is it hot, it is humid, so maybe the rain will kind of cool things down. I'll see y'all in a bit. It's a beautiful church right out here, caught my attention. I'll go check it out. And they have these bean bags you can lay out in this park. Pretty cute. It was raining, but that's the church. Looks very Catholic more than, is it Buddhist here? I'm not even sure, but here's the church. Gorgeous, take a picture of that. I'll just give you guys a glimpse of that. Now I'm gonna get something to eat. If y'all could smell in here, it smells so good. I got a bakery over here. And there's one over here. Not too many things open this early, so I'm gonna have to grab a grab and go place and then eat lunch or dinner on the tour. But I can't find nothing to get quickly. I only have like an hour. I wanna see more things over here. Oh, where can I get some food today? Oh, where? Get some food today. Oh my God, guys, I'm in Singapore and there is a Garrett popcorn here in Singapore. I kid you not. There's a little bag. There's Ali making my little Chicago mix. She even shakes it like the people in Chicago. Wow. I'm in heaven. Okay, I ordered a small, and when I say small, it was small, the size of my hand. But perfect size for when you're on a diet, and I can't wait to eat that. It'll be my dessert. I still gotta find my rice, but Garrett's popcorn in Chicago. Chicago, now you have it. They also got designer popcorn here at Garrett's. I still can't believe it's Garrett's. That is too funny. Shout out to Garrett's popcorn. I will be back before we leave, people. Since I'm short on time, I ordered at Starbucks. I only have less than a half hour to get back to the hotel for my tour. So I got a turkey egg sandwich and a flat white coming up. Thank you very much. It's pretty cool when you order in at Starbucks, they give you a real plate, a real mug. We need that in America. Save, talk about recycling. Everything smells good here. Everything's clean. It's like, I've always heard about that, but it's so true. It's good. I'll give y'all a little chat time while I'm eating my little meal right quick. About 30 minutes. And did you guys watch Miss Universe? I had to watch it on YouTube from Singapore, but I already knew who the winner was. But shout out to Miss South Africa. Brown skin girl. Skin just like her. That was so cool. I like Puerto Rico too, but ironically, blonde, blue eyes, Puerto Rican. Okay. I guess we're all in shapes and colors. But so, isn't Puerto Rico a part of America? But not a country, but maybe in the pageants it's different. Anyway, so I was so excited about that. Good. Yeah, so I have 36 hours and I'm gonna make the most out of that. I thought it'd be easier to just do a guided tour. It was only, I think, $20 and it's guided, so in English. That's a good deal. That's it. I'll see you guys in a bit. Stay tuned. Now, if I was ghetto, I would take this mug with me, but it would be nice because if you go to jail in a foreign country, you may not get out, so. We saw a sign at the airport saying smuggling drugs into this country or out is punishable by death. Yes, y'all. Now, we definitely need that in the States. But I'm not even getting Advil here. I don't know what kind of tour this is going to be. It is pouring down rain now. It's still hot and humid, but I'll be in the van. But when they get out, I gotta get an umbrella from the hotel, I guess. But I'm adventurous, so here we go. Gotta get my hair wet. Raindrops are falling on my head. Raindrops are falling on my head. Look at Coach. They got their big old display. Bye, Coach. From America. That's their store, how cool. Rooftop like a crazy rich Asian. I think we're going there tonight if it's not raining to see the firework or laser. I hope you can see it with all this rain. That is cool, iconic. When I tell you it smells good everywhere I go in Singapore, even in my hotel, but this is a restaurant. You can see them making the pastries and things. How cool is that? There's a window in front of me and I can still smell the chocolate. It is divine. Look at that, people. And then look at the artistry over there in the back. I don't know if I can get it. Do a close up. There we go. It's cooking in a pot. Are those chitlins? It's like a glass display right here in the hotel, so that's pretty cool. And I'm just here waiting for my tour. The hotel was nice enough to give me an umbrella for the wet, get my hair wet. I think it's a cool fireplace over here. Let me check out this fireplace. Wonderful. Bring it out. Look at that. Y'all, I'm getting paid for this. Can y'all believe that? Getting paid. And we're hiring. All the airlines are hiring. If you want a job like this, now's your time. Welcome to the Botanical Garden. Celebrity Orchid Garden. Let's see. Who's in here? All right, good old Andre's flower. Right there. Don't know who she is. Maybe somebody else does. For the Chinese. We could find her an American somewhere.
Expensive shoes, ask your partner to hop you on. Alright? So that's the Merlion statue. So I was telling you the head is made of the image of Singapore being founded by the prince, and the bottom is because
close up. I can zoom and see if anybody's up there. I think I'm going there tonight to see the laser show. Reclamation.
the Marina Bay Sands. What exactly is the Marina Bay Sands? It is what's termed in Singapore an integrated resort. Why is it called integrated resort? Because it's actually a casino hotel. Now, why does it just name Marina Bay Sands Casino Hotel? Because it's illegal. Now, Singapore started out as a country that had no legal framework or legality to have a gambling place. Only way is to jump on a ship, cruise to nowhere or somewhere, and you can gamble out in the sea, or take a bus all the way up to Malaysia. Right? So what happens? So what happens is, when we were mooting this idea, the public wasn't very pro-casinos. So what we wanted to do was put on safety nets. So the first safety net is, you build it, don't make it obvious. So no advertising, no word, no branding of the word casino, except integrated resort. But by the time the whole hoo-ha happened, everybody knows it's a casino. Right? But foreigners like you don't know. Right? Second rule is that for locals, in order for us to go in, we need to fork out $150.
Just to go in.
So before we even start playing, we're down on our luck. Right? That's two. And number three is the favorite among many.
Yeah.
Let's say you, sir, are a heavy gambler. Let's just say. So let's say he's a heavy gambler.
I bet I'm not.
I'm not insane. So basically, the control is not reactive, it's proactive. So she knows he's a heavy gambler by the amount of the three houses that he has lost. So what happens, she can pick up the phone, call the hotline and say, can you please bar my husband from going in? Yes, the locals, give the name, ID number, and bam, you can't even buy the $150 levy. So the control is in the family, right? So that's how we control the casino. So essentially, it is a casino where do you think it's a casino? Aha! Everybody says the top. Imagine you take $1 million credit line and you lose everything. What happened? Exactly. So you want to limit that, right? So it's actually at the basement. Yeah, you're right. So in right in the foreground, you see this building that looks like wave. Yes. Waves. That's where the left and center is the shopping mall. The one on the
Never thought I'd wake up and I'd be in Singapore. How do I know I'm in Singapore? Marina Bay, right there. Crazy Rich Asian. I'm going about right there tonight. But it's still raining. Stop raining.